The rhizome is a concept developed by Deleuze and Guattari that can be defined as an acentered multiplicity. Wait, what? What the does that mean? Okay, multiplicities can be understood as neither subject nor object, only magnitudes and dimensions that can't increase in number without changing in nature. Take temperature, for example. 80 degrees Fahrenheit has a certain feeling to it. Any adding or subtracting of degrees results in a different feeling. Compare that to, say, adding or subtracting from a bag of marbles. Whether you add to it or take from it, it's still a bag of marbles. This is a quantitative difference versus a multiplicity, which is more of a qualitative difference. So anyway, that's a multiplicity, and while a rhizome is just a bunch of multiplicities put together in a way that has no structure at all. So why is the concept of the rhizome useful? Well, to think with it is to unveil the many ways that you can approach a thought or activity. Helps question hierarchies and binaries, and provides us with a way to see how everything can be multiple and interrelated. To illustrate this concept, let's compare a tree with ginger. First, imagine a tree with roots extending into the ground, a trunk coming up out of the ground, and branches that go into the sky. Thinking has been historically imagined like this, based on the idea of hierarchies and categorizations. Much of Western philosophy stems from this thinking and can be seen in the structure of our schools, corporations, and even things like child development theories. All of these present a beginning, which is at the bottom, and one desired end to meet at the top. Where the tree is rooted in logical, ginger growth really doesn't make any sense at all. It has no top or bottom and goes off in every which way. Deleuze and Guattari describe six characteristics of the rhizome. Notice how they fit the image of ginger. Connectivity and heterogeneity means that any point can be connected to any other, no matter how similar or different. Multiplicity, remember temperature. A signifying rupture, which means the rhizome can be broken off at any point, but it'll always start up again. And cartography and decalcomania, which makes us think of the rhizome as a map, something that's always open and can be entered at any point. Think about it. Is there really a starting point to reading a map? What these six characteristics help us see is that the rhizome is not just a thing, but probably more of a process, an imminent process that allows us to question hierarchical organization. The rhizome's emphasis is not on what is or what was, but more on what can become of it. Some other illustrations of rhizomes might be the internet, especially a website like Wikipedia, or crabgrass. These things don't have a central root, origin, or logical pattern to their growth. These examples and their rootlessness help us envision how we might oppose what has been called rational approaches to knowledge. To think with the rhizome is to give up, at least for a little, beginnings and endings, tops and bottoms, and that comfortable shade of the tree. Because remember, rhizomes are always in the middle and suggest ways of rehabilitating thought as a creative and dynamic enterprise, where things aren't just this or that, but always and, and, and.